नेक्स्ट इज द बोलजानो वर्सरस थ्योरम। दिस थ्योरम सेज दैट एवरी इनफाइनाइट बाउंडेड सेट हैज अ लिमिट पॉइंट। एवरी इनफाइनाइट बाउंडेड सबसेट ऑफ आर यू कैन से दैट हैज अ लिमिट पॉइंट। So now just see the proof of this. What is given to us? Given that we are having a subset of R which is having infinitely many elements and which is bounded also. So this is given to us. So let S be any infinite bounded set. So if it is infinite bounded subset of R, then the completeness property, order completeness property, what will we have? Order completeness property says that any infinite subset of real number has a suprema if it is bounded from above. So if it is bounded, clearly it is bounded from above, right? So we are having a subset of real number which is infinite, which is bounded. So therefore, by order completeness property, of R, there must exist a suprema in R. Say it is capital M. Now, what is the meaning of suprema or supremum? If your M is the supremum or least upper bound for the set S, what does it mean? It means all the elements of set S, they are less than or equals to capital M. And this is true for every element of the set S. Then this capital M is the suprema for the set S. Or you can say set S is bounded above by the number capital M. And this M is the real number. It is exist in R. This point is clear. Now what we will claim that this capital M is the limit point of a set S. So we'll claim that ये जो कैपिटल एम है विच इज द सुप्रीमा फॉर द सेट एस दैट इज द लिमिट पॉइंट फॉर द सेट एस। वंस अगेन सी व्हाट इज गिवन टू अस। वी आर हैविंग एनी इनफाइनाइट सबसेट ऑफ रियल नंबर विच इज बाउंडेड। वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट दिस हैज अ लिमिट पॉइंट। सो वी कंसीडर एस टू बी एनी इनफाइनाइट बाउंडेड सबसेट ऑफ आर। And since we know that by the order completeness property of R, that whenever we are having a set which is infinite and it is bounded from above, there always exists a suprema in R. Say it is capital M. So let M be the least upper bound for the set S. It means all the elements of set S, they are less than equal to capital M. Next, we will claim that this capital M is the limit point of the set S. Now for limit point, what we required, we want to find out an open interval, a neighborhood whose intersection with S is phi, right? So we want to find out that. So now next, for given epsilon greater than zero, clearly M minus epsilon is not an upper bound. Of the set S, why this is so? Why M minus epsilon is not an upper bound? Yes.
Because M is the upper bound.
No, M is upper bound. Nee, M is least upper bound. If M is least upper bound, then M minus epsilon cannot be the upper bound, right? So if m minus epsilon is not an upper bound, it means all the elements of set S, they are not less than equal to m minus epsilon. It means there must exist an element in S which is greater than this number, right? So that means what? There exists an element in S such that your y is greater than m minus epsilon. Is this point clear? What we claim, that we are claiming that this capital M is the limit point. So for proving M to be the limit point, we require to show that there is a neighborhood around M whose intersection with the set S, deleted neighborhood, this should be non-empty. This thing we want to show, right? The deleted neighborhood of M intersection with the set S should be non-empty. If this thing hold, then it means your capital M is the limit point for the set S, right? So we require to find out an open interval, a neighborhood around M such that its intersection is non-empty. Okay, so now further humne kya kaha hai, since your capital M is the least upper bound, then clearly M minus epsilon, where epsilon is the positive number, it cannot be the upper bound for the set S. If it is not the upper bound, it means all the elements of the set S, they are not less than equal to M minus epsilon. It means there must exist some element in S which is greater than this number, right? So say it is y is any member of S such that y is greater than m minus epsilon. Agar aisa nahi hold hoga, to it means sare ke sare element m minus epsilon se chote hain. It means your m minus epsilon is the least upper bound, but this is contradiction because it is given that capital M is the suprema of the set S. Okay, so therefore there must exist some y in S which satisfying this condition. Now clearly this is less than equal to capital M because all the numbers of set S should be less than equal to capital M because capital M is the least upper bound for the set S, and further it is clearly less than M plus epsilon. Is this point clear? Moreover, you can take this strictly less than. Right? So there must exist some y in S such that y is strictly greater than m minus epsilon. And it is strictly less than m plus epsilon. So what we have, y belonging to the open interval m minus epsilon, comma m plus epsilon, except capital M. Okay, so we get an open interval, we get a neighborhood around the capital number, this capital M, okay, such that your y is a member of this. Is this point clear? Agar y equal to m aa jata hai, then again we can choose some another y1 which is strictly less than capital M. We know this thing always hold because they are dense. We know that between any two real number there lie a real number, there lie a rational number. So ek aur hame number mil hi jayega which is strictly less than capital M. Okay, so we can always find a number y which is belonging to the deleted neighborhood of capital M. So we get an open interval which contains this capital M. So clearly this is the neighborhood of capital M, and y is a member of S which belongs to the deleted neighborhood of capital M. It means the intersection of m minus epsilon comma m plus epsilon, minus capital M, deleted capital M, intersection with the set S is non-empty because Y already exist kar raha hai, jo ki S ko bhi belong kar raha hai aur isko bhi belong kar raha hai. So it means inki intersection mein hoga Y. this point is clear, implies that your capital M is the limit point of the set S. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So whenever you are having an infinite bounded subset of R, there always exists a limit point. Right? Moreover, jo suprema hai ya infima hai, they are the limit points for the set S. Ab kyunki ye bounded hai, it is bounded below also. So there must exist a infima in R. तो इनफीमा के भी सेम आप केस ले सकते हो एंड यू कैन प्रूव दैट दैट इनफीमा इज द लिमिट पॉइंट ऑफ द सेट एस. सो सिंस वी वांट टू प्रूव ओनली वन लिमिट पॉइंट, सो वी गेट एटलीस्ट वन लिमिट पॉइंट एग्जिस्ट इन द केस ऑफ बाउंडेड सेट. अगर हम बाउंडेड कंडीशन को रिमूव करते हैं, देन कैन यू गिव एनी एग्जाम्पल ऑफ इनफाइनाइट सबसेट, इनफाइनाइट सेट विच इज हैविंग नो लिमिट पॉइंट, which is having infinitely many limit points and which is having exactly one limit point. Can you give any example for that? If you remove the condition bounded from the previous theorem, this theorem, can you give any example for a infinite set which is having no limit point, exactly one limit point, and having infinitely many limit points? An example of an infinite set of natural numbers, you can say they are infinitely many, right? And they are having no limit point. A set having exactly one limit point. Please mute yourself. Yes. Anyone else?
1 upon n, n approaches to nat- n belongs to natural numbers.
But this is not unbounded. This is bounded set. You have to give an example of an unbounded infinite set which is having exactly one limit point. Can you think of it? Yes, anyone? Yes, you can make this two. You add set of natural number also. Iska koi limit point nahi hai. Iska exactly one limit point hai. Aur combined ye set unbounded hai. Getting my point? This set is having exactly one limit point. This set is having no limit point. The union of these two sets, they are not bounded, they are infinite in nature and having exactly one limit point. Is it clear? So you can make, is it clear to you, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Now just see the third case. You have to find an infinite set which is not bounded but having infinitely many limit points. This is very simple. You can say set of real numbers, you can say set of rational numbers, you can say set of irrational numbers. All are infinite sets, all are not bounded but having infinitely many limit points.